In this video, I'm going to be walking you through the very first steps when creating your own Unito flow. I'll be covering connecting your tools to Unito, like Jira, Trello, Airtable, what permissions you're going to need in your tools, how to connect your blocks of work, like your projects, your boards, and flow direction. Do you need it two ways, one way, maybe a mixture of both? All right, let's get into it. Okay, the first step is to select Create Flow in the top right-hand corner. You'll then be shown Unito's Flow Builder guiding you through the five-step process. On the right-hand side, you'll find helpful guides along your way. The first step is to connect our tools, so we're going to select Start here. In this step, we can connect two different tools together or even the same tools. I'm going to start with Trello on the left. Selecting this drop-down here, I'll be able to see all of the tools Unito integrates with. Simply select your tool, and the next step is selecting the user account that we want to use in this flow. Now, if you've already connected some user accounts to Unito, you'll see them listed here. If not, you'll be prompted to connect your new Trello account. You can use your personal Trello user or a generic Trello bot user. We recommend creating a generic user in your tool, like a bot or a service account, to build your flows with if you can. It's also possible to launch your flow using your personal user account to start with, and then edit your flow later on to switch that user out to a bot user if you're not quite ready to set that up now. You also want to make sure that this user you're selecting has access to the blocks of work, like your boards, that you need to connect. And you want to make sure they have access over time as well. That's how we're able to access your items and sync changes. Each tool requires different user permissions, but for Trello, you just need to be a member of the boards you want to sync. As you can see, I've connected two users already, so I'm going to select the Unito bot and then select the board I want to sync. I want to sync this board with Airtable, so I'm going to pick Airtable on the right-hand side, and I've already connected my Airtable user account, and then I get to select the table I want to sync with my Trello board. Now with Airtable, it's a little bit different. I have to create this last modified time field in order for Unito to sync with my table. Okay, we can confirm that, and the next step is setting our flow direction. Here I want to make the flow bi-directional. I want to take Trello cards and sync them into Airtable, and Airtable records and sync them into Trello. Great, so we can confirm that. Now let's have a look at another example here with different tools. I have Asana and Jira that I haven't connected yet. Now with Asana, it's super easy. With most tools, if you're logged into Asana already, you'll just be automatically connected in using OAuth. From here, we can then select our user account and then the project that we want to sync with. Now with Jira, it's a little bit more complicated. As you can see here, there'll be a few extra steps you'll need to take to connect Jira with Unito. From here, we need to put our Jira URL in, and from here, you'll see a few extra steps with configuring Unito in Jira. Now, a few of the tools, they'll include these sort of steps you need to take in the tool themselves. In Jira, we need to create an application link, and I'm going to speed through this step here and paste in a bunch of information, but you'll see when we go back into Unito app, we'll have all this information given to us in the step-by-step guide. So here's all the steps that I just took with all that information, and we can go ahead and authorize. Now Jira is the one that includes probably the most steps, but if you get stuck, you've got our little chat bubble in the bottom right hand corner, and you can chat with our friendly team there. Okay, so that's all connected. We can pick our Jira user account and search for our Jira project we want to sync with Asana. Now, this example, I'm going to make it one way. I only want Asana tasks to sync into Jira, and I don't want Jira issues to sync into Asana. In a later step, though, I can actually choose to have certain Jira fields sync back into Asana. So, for example, comments and status can sync back. Okay, that's all done. The next step is setting our rules and mappings.